Welcome to my channel, guys. So the topic of today's videos are movies so bad that they are good. Okay, this is the kind of movie we're going to be talking about in this video. It is called Tammy in the T-Rex. Apparently this came out back in like 1994, but I haven't heard anything about this movie up until the day I stumbled across it on the new movies that was added to the Shudder app. So the plot for this movie is absolutely ridiculous, okay? We have like this crazy mad scientist doctor that builds like a realistic animatronic T-Rex thingy in his lab, and he decides to put a human brain inside that T-Rex thingy and give it life. It never actually even really explained in the movie exactly why he wanted to do this. Why would you want to put a human brain in the T-Rex? He'll probably be like, I don't know, just cause. Well, actually, he did go on in one scene of the movie about how, like, that was supposed to give human beings immortality or something, but I'm kind of failing to see the connection between immortality and creating an animatronic T-Rex and connected it to a human brain. Anyways, like, I'm thinking way too hard about this. Movies like that, you gotta turn off your brain if you want to get any type of enjoyment out of it, okay? So anyways, so he decides to put a human brain in this T-Rex, and he ends up abducting from a hospital this young man who is in a coma after being mauled by a lion. And how exactly the young man got mauled by a lion is also absolutely ridiculous. And this poor high school kid named Michael is played, by the way, by young Paul Walker. Like, I guess that was one of those times when Paul Walker was really unknown and he was just taking any role, like, ever. Just saying. The mad doctor abducts this guy from the hospital. Long story short, he puts his brain in the T-Rex thingy, disposes of his body, and now poor Michael is a T-Rex, okay? And then Michael ends up breaking free from the mad scientist's lab and goes on like this crazy rampage looking for his high school sweetheart Tammy, played by young Denise Richards, who I'm guessing was also taking any role that was offered to her back then. But then again, Denise Richards was never a great actress to begin with, so I think she still kind of would take any role now. It's a weird ass movie and it's absolutely ridiculous, like I keep on saying. But you know what I liked about it though? As bad as this movie was and as stupid as this movie was, it was kind of entertaining, okay? In a really trashy sort of way. That's the kind of movie that I feel like if you smoke, you watch this kind of movie high. I personally don't smoke, so I had a few beers while watching this. Drinking my usual drink of choice, which is wine, during such a movie seemed like an insult to the wine. It's more like a beer type of movie, okay? I feel like every single person involved in the making of this movie, they knew damn well that they was making a bad movie and they committed to it, okay? They wasn't trying to be pretentious with it. They wasn't trying to make this movie anything other than what it is. They made this movie campy as hell, which is the only way this type of movie could work. Now, this is classified as a horror comedy, and the version that Shudder has is a little bit gory. I wouldn't call it like super gory, but it does have some gory scenes in it. When I was reading up on the movie after I finished watching it, I read on the movie's trivia page that usually this movie is shown in an edited version where they cut out all of the gory scenes to make it a PG-13 movie. I'm glad as hell I didn't stumble on the edited version on the Shudder, because I feel like actually the gore is part of the fun about this movie. If I would have seen the edited version of this, I would have enjoyed this a lot less, okay? Gore is one of the selling points for this movie, and honestly, looking at the gory scenes in it, I don't even understand why they felt the need to edit it out to make it a PG-13, because them scenes was not like, even though they're gory and gross, they're not like scary or disturbing. It's like a funny type of gore, you know, like really cheesy type of gore, really like over the top, really the type of gore that you know damn well that's not real. Like, they have the dinosaur chewing off people's heads, they have him stomping on people and leaving them flat like a pancake. None of it looks realistic, none of it looks really scary. It's more like a gory, but like in a funny type of way, okay? It's like gory, goofy, and cheesy, not like gory and disturbing. But anyways, the acting in this movie is a very typical B-movie acting, okay? That's all I gotta say about this. But I do gotta say that the animatronic dinosaur that they used in this movie was pretty damn good. Like, I really like it. It's another selling point for this movie. And also the dinosaur kind of out-acted everybody else involved, okay? Like, the dinosaur's acting was on point compared to the rest of the cast. And I'm not even saying that in an insulting way to the cast. Again, this is like a typical trashy B-movies, so they acting accordingly. Aside from the bloody and gory scenes, which was pretty cool, they had a whole bunch of really absurd and ridiculous scenes that involved like a T-Rex picking up a phone in a payphone booth and trying to phone his girlfriend. And then when he did finally get reunited with the girlfriend, he was trying to play charades with her to tell her who exactly he is, because obviously he can't talk anymore. They had a scene where he picked up a mirror for the first time after being turned into a T-Rex, then looked at himself and roared in horror. Like, it's just a very ridiculous movie, y'all. Like, this is the type of movie you gotta see for yourself just to see how ridiculous it is. But like I said, I enjoyed it in a very goofy and campy type of way. I'm not gonna lie though, it took me a while to get into it because it did have like a pretty long opening until the guy actually turned into a T-Rex, when they showed like this backstory about their little love affair, and like the girl, she had this crazy stalker boyfriend that keep on popping up. All that high school dramas, all that shit was not interesting to me. Once the guy turned into a dinosaur though, it just got so ridiculous from that point on. It was like a train wreck that I couldn't stop watching. So like, I would recommend this movie to you for when you just feel the need to watch something really trashy but kind of fun. Like, I don't know about you all, but I get in those type of moods sometimes. But if you do decide to watch this movie, I would definitely recommend you to watch the gore cut and not the edited version, because like I said, a huge part of the fun of this movie is the gore. On IMDb, this movie has a pretty low score of 4.1. I mean, I wouldn't give it a score that low, but then again, I can't really give it like a high score, because this wasn't by no means a great or even a good movie, but it was fun. So I would give it like a 5 out of 10, okay? Because while I enjoyed it, I can't seriously like give this movie anything higher than a 5, because it's just so damn bad. But it was fun though. Not even gonna lie, when it first started and like I realized where the whole plot was going, I'm not even gonna lie, hear me out on this one here. I thought for a second, so like, RoboCop with dinosaurs? I mean, we all know RoboCop is much better quality movie than this shit, but I'm just saying, they took a guy's brain and they put it technically in a robot, in a dinosaur robot. So like, RoboCop with dinosaurs, get it? And on that note, thank you guys for watching. Like this video if you enjoyed my review, subscribe to my channel, all that good stuff, and I'll see you in the next video, okay? Bye.